Hi guys, Lewis from Vev here, and today I'm going to be taking you through how to build an interactive website in Vev, all without having to write a single line of code. So, let's jump into it. In today's web design market, interactivity isn't just a nice to have, it's something that users have come to expect when they visit websites, even if they're not subconsciously thinking about it. What separates successful and unsuccessful content is the ability to keep your users' attention. In fact, many companies use average time on page as a key metric now to gauge success. No-code tools like Vev make it easy for anyone to create slick, interactive websites without the traditional costs, timelines, or dev expertise. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to bring interactivity and fluidity to your web content. So the first thing we're going to be looking at is interactivity. So probably quite obvious to a lot of you, but interactivity is the physical, or in this case digital, interaction between the user and the website. And in Vev, out of the box, there are a lot of elements that you can add to your project to allow the user to interact with your content. The first component we're going to be looking at is something called labeled images, which is exactly as it sounds, an image with clickable labels. It's great for creating hotspots on a map or highlighting features on a product. You can even add personalized tooltips and reveal content to make it look exactly the way you want it to. If we open up the contextual menu, we'll be able to see that we can add points for all the different labels. This is relative to the X and Y axis and is done in percentages. We can add a caption on hover and decide what this says, have a multi-line caption, and we can also assign a widget. So the widget refers back to what I said earlier, where you can add content which appears when you click on said label. And finally, we can add animation to this so we can make it appear and disappear however we want it to. Next up is show and hide. Show and hide is an add-on which you can attach to elements like images or text to trigger the appearance of different pieces of content. It's important to remember that you need to attach the add-on to the content that you want to appear. Once the add-on is added, the contextual menu will appear and you can decide if you want this to show by default, set the triggers for the show and hide, as well as set the animation for how this appears and disappears. Please note that you will need to name the triggers appropriately for them to appear in this list of elements. So next up we have the 3D object viewer. So the render that you see here of this little spaceman is interactive. I can click and drag him around to view him from different angles, and I can even set up hotspots to highlight information about his suit. If we open up the contextual menu, in the first tab we can upload our own 3D model. This element currently only supports uploading .glb and .gltf file formats, so you may need to convert them. Once the file is uploaded, we can preview it here in this menu, including having the ability to click and drag it around. In the next tab, we can assign hotspots to our 3D object simply by clicking the preview on the left-hand side. Once a hotspot is added, it will appear on the right-hand side, and in here we can add content to appear once this hotspot is clicked. This works very similar to how show and hide works. In the poster image tab, we can assign an image that will appear before the 3D object has loaded. This works well for mobile devices, but also for computers with slow internet speeds. And finally, in the settings tab, we can enable auto-rotate. We can also enable scroll activated zoom, and we can choose which color we want the hotspot to appear. The image compare element can add another level of visual storytelling to your project, creating an interactive before and after effect. This one's really popular for showcasing the inside of a product, and I've also seen it been used before to show the effects of climate change. Featuring a draggable handle, we can also open the settings to hide this handle or even animate it to move automatically. In the design panel on the right hand side, we can select the images that we want to showcase for both the left and the right side. Our final recommendation for interactive components are carousels. Carousels are a great way to showcase imagery and information. They condense information into smaller sections for your page while offering interactivity. In Vev, there are a handful of different types of carousels, including image slideshow, 3D carousel, card slider, and stat cards. Next up, let's take a look at fluidity. So you might be asking yourself, what is the difference between interactivity and fluidity? So by definition, interactivity is a computer's response to a user's input, whereas fluidity is how a page flows from start to finish. So by adding a little bit of movement, maybe using something like horizontal scroll or just adding some page animations, we can easily give our page a really premium feel.
The Scroll Speed add-on is a great way to create parallax effects. It lets you set the scroll speed of a specific element so it moves at a different speed to the rest of the page. You can even set it to a minus value if you want it to move in the opposite direction of your scroll. In this example here, you'll see that I have a mixture of different speeds so that all of the shapes move around uniquely. Within the same section, I've also used an add-on called Mouse Move Parallax. This add-on allows you to add a little bit of movement to your page based on the mouse movement and gives you the illusion of interactivity. When you move your mouse cursor around, the element will move with or against the mouse. If we open up the settings, we can adjust the movement factor and select whether it moves with or against the cursor. Animations are an obvious and easy way to bring movement to your page, adding subtle charm even to the simplest of designs. In Vev, animations are an add-on so you can attach them to any element. You can then play with four different types of animation triggers: load, click, hover, and scroll. And if you really want, you can combine all four. When selecting a trigger, we can choose from a list of preset animations, or if you want, you can create your own animations by selecting custom. Now, for one of my favourite sections, and one popular amongst Vev users too, Scrollytelling. Scrollytelling creates a smooth transition in the background from one image or video to another. It provides a great storytelling opportunity, letting foreground content slide over the hero visual as you scroll. Stack at least two Scrollytelling sections back to back to create this effect. In the settings, you can also add a zoom effect to bring further fluidity to your design, as well as being able to adjust the transition between the two sections. Onto our final component, horizontal scrolling. The horizontal scroll section offers a refreshing way to display content and change up the flow of the page by literally taking it in a different direction. Just like Scrollytelling, you'll need at least two of the same sections back to back for this to work correctly. Inside the design editor, these sections will appear vertically stacked, but if we hit preview, that's when the magic will happen.
Now that we've been through these two design concepts, you can add them to your project to give your pages a premium feel. But sometimes it's good to remember that less is more. Try not to add too many of these elements to your project because it might overwhelm your user and they're probably gonna bounce just as quickly as if you didn't have any of them. For more videos like this, check out vev.design/learn. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one.